2 hours. Guys, the dog needs to rest at least 6 hours because that's 11 time.
Error would be to let this rise up.
1 hour.
This day.
What is he doing like that? It's okay. You have to mix the dough just like that.
Do you want to take it off when the cheese is a nice dark deep brown and the crust it?
Io l'ho detto questo, non mi incidia proprio.
She burned the cheese. Hello guys from Maestro Vittorio Copelli and welcome back to my channel. I'm a pro pizzaiolo, own a pizza place in Los Angeles. I used to own a pizza place in Italy. I've been making pizza since I was 8 years old. Also today in 2020, I'm also a YouTuber full time and then I teach online how to make the pizza. Pizza is not a trend. Pizza is a lifestyle. Today is going to be very, very different videos. Today I'm going to react to 2 most viewed pizza videos on YouTube. It's more an instructional react than offensive react because here I don't want to offend anyone. And this is my first reaction. I hope you like it. If you like it, please thumbs up and consider it to subscribe. If we are going to make a lot of views in this video, maybe next week I'm going to do more. We have 24 million views on this video from Tasty. The best homemade pizza you ever eat. That's bad.
Honestly, making pizza only takes a few simple ingredients. What you're gonna need is a little bit of warm water. It's gonna activate a good amount of dried yeast. A bit of sugar.
Here.
Extra virgin olive oil. It's gonna, one, make your dough a little bit easier to work with. It's also gonna add.
Allora,
cioè, capite che cosa ho detto?
Prima errore.
The olive oil makes it easy to work with. Cioè, praticamente aiuta la
crescita.
No, la crescita, dice che aiuta il modo di lavorare l'impasto, l'olio. No, guys, the olive oil is to cook better the pizza, that helps the cooking process to cook a little bit more crunchy and faster the pizza. That's the why, the reason of the olive oil. Either way, most of the time you have the lower temperature in the oven, that's when you put olive oil. This way it cooks a little bit more faster.
And then you're gonna see that your yeast is gonna start to produce a little bit of bubbles and it just means that it's kind of alive.
That's true.
If you don't see any change.
This is true, that what she's saying now, that the yeast in the water starts to make a little bit of bubble. Yes, that's alive and it's correct.
Once we're happy that we're not gonna have like water or flour all over the place, we can toss it onto our board and start kneading it. So kneading is one of those things that like people tend to not do enough. Set the timer and do it for 10 minutes. You wanna be.
Set the timer and do it for 10 minutes. No! You knead the dough until it's everything together, so you cannot set up the time. After all, she's doing a great job.
You press the dough and it springs back right away.
She made a really good mixing part. So, and she's correct also. When you press and goes out, that's correct.
Movimenti, yeah.
Sta facendo un buon lavoro.
Now what we want to do is get like the really gorgeous top part of the dough. You can just pull the sides of the dough from the outside.
See how she's touching the dough? Press and
delicate.
Press. She's delicate, so that's a good thing. You have to be calm, generous. Calm.
Come una donna,
bravo.
Devi toccare delicatamente.
Bravo.
In, so that it makes a nice ball on the other side. So you can let this rise for an hour if you don't have a ton of time. Even better would be to let this rise.
1 hour. 1 hour.
Guarda, ti sei lo stomaco, diventa un sasso.
1 hour, guys. No. Again, you raised the minimum of 6 hours. Vabbè, continuiamo. This is what makes me really
siamo
mad.
Siamo positivi, pensiamo al fatto che magari la reimpasto la fa riposare un altro poco. Speriamo.
Overnight. So the one on the left.
Wait, aspetta, overnight.
Vedi, 24.
So I prefer clean. So you can let this rise for an hour if you don't have a ton of time. Even better would be to let this rise overnight. So the one on the left is one that's been.
Look at this though. 24 hours, 1 hour. You cannot say to prove the dough for 1 hour or overnight. The go or is not you go fast or you go too far away, this, because after 24 hours with this amount of yeast, what happens is the dough, it gets overproof. When the overproof start to become acid, it's no good anymore. So you have to go something in between. If you put that amount of yeast, you keep the dough in the fridge if you want to stay for 24 hours, so it slows down the fermentation. Or you use it after 6 hours.
It's still going to be a great flavor, it's still going to be a great texture. So the longer you let this process go, just like the more flavor and the more complexity is going to be in your dough. And what we're going to...
Diciamo che lei doveva fare una via di mezzo, perché ha fatto 24 ore così stralipato.
That's what I say. She's saying that the more hours, the more flavor. It's not.
What we do now is just bring this dough back to life. So a lot of work has happened.
Bring this dough back to life.
No. No, ormai è morta.
Let's resuscitiamo. Resuscitiamola. Let's get back to life. Let's go.
With all this yeast, and it's been a little bit uneven in the way that it's grown, and that's just like a totally normal process. So we're gonna turn it out, and we're gonna knead it again for another minute or two. Nothing different about this process. Again, we're just evening out the bubbles that are inside the dough. And we're gonna do that shaping thing again. So use your pinkies, if you will, to kind of push to make it into a cute ball. And if you're using store-bought pizza dough, you want to do this as well. So knead it for a minute or two and leave it out at room temperature while you're doing all of your other pizza prep. And then we're going to cut it. So as you can see, now that we've cut into this, you can look at that.
Hold on, this part is a little bit confusing. What I think is that probably there was a mistake that she made, but she wanted to recover that because she went overproof that, but she forgot about the one from 1 hour. But let's go back, 24 million views.
One thing that you want to recreate from a pizzeria in your own home kitchen is getting your oven as hot as it possibly can. One thing that's going to help that...
That's true. So a nice thumbs up what she just said. Because the most is at the oven, the better will come out your pizza. That's correct.
And it's water. And then there's whole tomatoes. And so those are the most intact, and those are the ones that I recommend. You can crush them with your hands, or as we're gonna do here, we're just gonna use an immersion blender.
Perfect. Yeah,
little safety PSA, if you're...
On the tomato side, she's doing a really good job, I have to say.
Have any leftover sauce, do not store it in the tin can, store it in a separate container, and make sure to throw the can away. Now let's talk cheese. The thing about pre-shredded cheese is it has some product on it that...
No, fresh mozzarella.
But no, what is this? It looks like French fries.
Yes.
Patatine fritte.
Prevents it from clumping in the bag. It just kind of doesn't allow things to melt as easily.
Carote. Carrots.
Yes. Easily, if you shred the cheese yourself.
Hopefully she's not going to put these French fries on the pizza.
It's going to be much softer. It's going to be a better flavor in the end. So if you have the option, we do recommend that you shred the cheese yourself.
Okay, yes. I mean, she's using the fresh...
One thing about using fresh mozzarella is that you can leave the chunks as big as you want. So if you're super cheesy, you're in good shape. What I like to do is kind of do my, like a finger poke, if you will, all over the dough. One, because it's so fun, but...
Did you see the dough, how it's going out? Because it's too stressed. So she's using after the dough was already overproof, and she kneaded again for more time. And then what happened is that too nervous the dough, so it gets too... she's...
Però aspetti, io non ho capito, adesso questa è la pizza che ha comprato, la pizza delle 24 ore o la pizza di un'ora? Non si capisce
quella di 24 ore,
perché lei ha fatto vedere tre impasti differenti, yeah. Quindi dovrebbe non essere si quella, capisce
quella di 24 ore dovrebbe essere. This is probably the 24 hours one, but let's continue to watch,
just kind of being really careful. You can use your fingers and come.
Same mistake.
I'm proprio difficoltà.
She's basically stretching like this. You make the, she's keep going making the dough too nervous and gets back. So again, you have to touch the dough little by little, like a delicate, like a woman. You just press. And then in this moment, I'm thinking my videos. Just check my videos. 24 million views.
Spread it, if you will, do a combo of things. I used to work at a pizza place, and the guy would actually put the dough like on the side of the table and kind of stretch it out.
Penso che sia un omicidio. La sta uccidendo la pizza. Tira, molla, non si capisce.
Now she's probably doing a good job this morning.
Wayne would let gravity work its magic and kind of let the dough strike.
Gravity work his magic. It looks like the watch.
L'orologio di Dalí.
But it's, I mean, you can do that. I mean, if you really need to, you can do that.
The job itself, it was kind of fun. I thought it was like a cool technique. He was able.
Look at this part.
Sì, sembra che a momenti.
It's too thin. It's definitely if she's going to use this.
No.
Dough, she's going to make a hole because it's too thin. And then what happened is because the dough is too nervous, is all the mixing part that it was wrong.
Gotcha. Able to do it much quicker and rotate and toss, catch.
She's doing a really good job, you know, but authentic, if the dough was properly made, she was not able to do that. She's able to do that because the dough was very nervous, so it goes back. But definitely is not the same dough that she was using 2 minutes ago, but she's doing right now she's doing a good job.
So now it's time to assemble our pizza. So we're going to use...
You see, this is already a different dough.
A turned over baking sheet. So this is going to act as our peel. Semolina. If you don't have that, you can use flour. But we just need something that the pizza won't stick to the bottom.
She's totally complete correct. Semolina or flour. Or rice flour is good in this case.
But also so that it helps us like move the pizza really quickly off our quote unquote peel and onto the preheated baking sheet. And then we're going to just reshape our pizza ever so slightly, restretch it out just a little bit. So when you're adding like...
Did you see the dough is going, keep it going back and back?
Sì, no, that's... mi piace.
Sauce and stuff to your dough. Just try and work.
So remember that the dough, when it gets back like this, in this case, even when you're going to bite, you're gonna be hurting your... chin area because it's gonna be too much chewing, too much nervous. So
quickly here, so like don't panic or anything, but if you are too slow, it's gonna be much harder to get the pizza off the peel and into the oven.
I just want to stop here 1 second. Giusto, questa cosa
sì, giusto.
Now one time, so the same time that you, the at the moment that you're going to put the sauce, you have to be fast because otherwise it's gonna stick the pizza to the peel or whatever you're using.
So we're gonna use just a ball of mozzarella, and I like to tear it up pretty small so that we can get like a really good even amount of cheese throughout the whole thing.
Spooky.
So you want to take it off when the cheese is a nice dark deep brown and the crust is...
Io l'ho detto questo, non mi incidia proprio.
She burned the cheese. Pizza, no. She burned the cheese.
Però lo fanno molti, devo dire che molti hanno questa cosa che bisogna bruciare la mozzarella.
She burned the cheese.
No.
Very important. When you're cooking the pizza at the lower temperature at your house, pre-cook the base with tomato sauce. Once it's almost done, take it out, add the cheese. This way you are not going to burn the cheese like this. And then you put it back in the oven, and then when the mozzarella start to melt it and bubbling, the dough, the pizza is ready. But in this case,
is like a golden brown as well.
Golden and brown.
And then we like to do a little bit of fresh basil on top. Again, I'm kind of a perfect biter, so I like everything to
At this point, yeah. look at this pizza. At least the basil outside.
È l'unica cosa non
bruciata sulla pizza. The basil outside is really good.
You like a good bite size. I don't want to like bite into a huge piece of basil and then like have it hang out of your mouth. You know what I mean? Like, yum. So that's like a classic margarita.
She's fine.
Look at the crunch. Yes. All right, cool. And now you eat. Really easy.
The crunch. I didn't say the crunch.
No?
The crunch. Listen to the crunch. There's no crunch. But let me see.
No, secondo me è croccante. Più che altro è cornicione perché me la sono vista dall'inizio come un impasto secco. Niente, quindi...
A little like pizza bianca, if you will, or like a white pizza, or
questa
pizza
without bianca,
sauce.
No sauce.
Now she's going to be a little bit of olive oil. Again, more cheese of your choice. We're using mozzarella. We put a bit of dried oregano on top of this as well. And this is going to go into the oven as is.
She's good. Let's see if she makes again a mistake.
sempre bruciato.
Yeah, this is like a super easy one. At the end of the cooking process, we actually...
Questo è sicuramente croccante, devo dire che è venuto proprio...
Un cracker. Dove sta il crackers?
Di là, non so. Io la farò venire più a un paniere, tu lo prendi, lo sbatti, ma rimane là duro proprio.
Oh, yeah, here's the pizza.
Grazie.
Let me see.
We added some fresh ricotta, which is like a really nice, fresh, cool bite. This is like a great summertime option, I feel like. And then even on top of that, a little bit of fresh pesto that we had. So this is like a really gorgeous, light, fresh pizza.
Devo fare complimenti su una cosa, perché effettivamente il pesto non va mai in cottura, va fresco, perché altrimenti si secca e diventa bruciato e duro anche quello.
I mean, she did a really good job on the ricotta and the pesto. But basically she's eating the crackers with ricotta and
it looks like luxurious, right? There's something about it. It's just very like, I don't know, it's like kid friendly, but it's also
no,
it's like bougie friendly.
I didn't hear the part.
And obviously the other fan favorite is a good classic pepperoni. So with that, it's just cheese, sauce, spicy pepperoni.
The pizza looks good. The mistake here is only the mixing part, and let's finish this.
Not even kidding, or like bacon and olive. It's like so salty.
I mean, after all, she did a really good job on the pizza, but two mistakes here is the dough and the cooking the cheese.
Mito, you wanna see the worst pizza in the world?
The worst pizza in the world?
Yes.
What, you think we should react that?
Yes. Of course, yes.
Let's see how this video goes, please, guys. Hopefully you like this video. Thumbs up. Please check out my channel and then comment below if you want to see more video reaction. Maybe of the worst pizzas in America. I would love to see it. I'm not gonna see it. You tell me.
It's too funny.
And subscribe. Ciao.
Ciao.